Docking stations have just got exciting. This is the HiDock H1, potentially one of the best docking stations for 2025 and beyond, or certainly one of the most unique at the very least. It's an 11-in-1 docking station for both Mac, Windows PCs, and even your phone. It's even got built-in ChatGPT for transcribing, summarizing, and even recording your phone calls and meetings from any device. So unboxing the HiDock H1, we have included a few really good quality cables. The USB-C to C cable, for example, supports super fast file transfers of up to 10 gigabits per second. We also get included a USB A to C cable, which will be best for Windows PCs, and then a 150 watt power supply. The HiDock H1 comes in this lovely suede bag, which alongside the high quality packaging and included cables, sets a really good bar for what we can expect from the HiDock itself. The HiDock H1 has this lovely, unique retro design, with first impressions of the build quality being pretty excellent. We have this beautiful knurled volume control, which acts as a button as well, and then some of these nice chunky buttons around the edges are for performing various actions like mute, answer, and record, a feature that we'll be exploring shortly. Lastly, we have this red slider, which is what's going to control your bi-directional noise cancellation, another feature we'll be checking out later on in the video. So as well as the HiDock H1, we also get this second attachment, which just clips onto the right-hand side of the HiDock via this magnetic port here. It's a really handy little feature actually. So this is actually a wireless earpiece, and once you pick it up in the middle of a meeting, it'll automatically switch your phone call or meeting to the earpiece, so you can have a true hands-free experience and still make use of some of the great features of the HiDock. What it's also going to do is minimize distractions. It's going to minimize the amount you need to be reaching for your phone, something that I feel strongly about in this day and age. Phones are such a huge distraction for us all. Moving on, port wise, we have a huge selection which should cover most scenarios. We do have an SD and micro SD card slot, both of which are 4.0 and support a maximum file transfer rate of 300 megabits a second. We also have a 2.5 gigahertz Ethernet port. This is fantastic because a lot of docking stations only have one, so this is a big win for the HiDock H1. Also on the back of the HiDock, we also have various USB-C and A ports, two HDMI ports which support up to 4K 60 hertz. With Windows PCs, you can connect through this and use two screens individually. However, when I'm using my MacBook, I have found that I can actually only make use of one of my displays. The second display only seems to mirror the first one, which is a little bit of a weird thing, but this is probably a MacBook problem. What I do love for my MacBook Pro M4 though is the port on the left hand side is actually fast enough to provide fast charging not only to my phone but even my MacBook, making it a great plug and play solution, especially when I'm in a bit of a rush. So let's really get into it now. The HiDock H1 has a couple of tricks up its sleeve. In fact, it's got several tricks up its sleeve. Firstly, without the need for additional drivers, it can actually record your phone calls, even iPhone calls, and go on to transcribe and summarize them. Just hit the Bluetooth button, connect to your Android or iOS phone, and you're good to go. You can even make use of the buttons without having to rely on your phone. Again, this is what I was saying earlier, it's minimizing the amount you actually have to physically reach for your phone and do something on it, therefore minimizing distractions. So once you've recorded a meeting and slash or phone call, you can head over to the HiNotes webpage. This is where you can download your transcription, which is essentially voice to text. You can grab the raw audio file there as well, and then you get your AI summary. What the built-in ChatGPT can do for you is assign labels to each individual speaker in the meeting and then go through the transcription and summarize key bits of information for you. I've recently become a huge advocate for AI note-taking. I think it's way more practical than doing it yourself. I think it's a huge time saver, and in some cases, it kind of gives you an advantage in the office over your peers as well. And this is especially true during longer meetings. Naturally, there is only so far a human's attention span will go. It just so happens that mine only lasts 5 minutes. Anyway, I should explain AI note-taking a little bit more. There's always this immediate concern that the AI might miss something. Well, it might, but because you have the transcription and the original recording, what you can do is search for a keyword and then literally listen back to that section of the meeting rather than just having to scrub through potentially hours of phone recordings. And if you get used to using AI notes and recording your phone calls, this is probably something that you weren't doing in the past anyway. You're probably just writing your notes down on a piece of paper, and I guarantee you will have missed something. Anyway, rather than talking about it, let's show you how it actually works in the real world, sort of. Obviously, I can't share my real world notes, and my fiance is a doctor, so it goes without saying she can't share hers either. So first things first, we need to check out that bi-directional noise cancellation and call recording with the HiDock H1.
So I'm lucky enough to live in the middle of Oxford City, so I'm out on my balcony at the moment towards the end of the day. So this is a really good time to test the bi-directional noise cancellation that comes with the HiDock H1. At the moment, we've got it set to its lowest. Now let's test it at its highest point. So now the HiDock H1 is set to its maximum noise cancellation. It's also worth noting that I'm currently recording my phone call via Bluetooth. It's connected to the HiDock directly. All you need to do is push the button in the top right to start that.
So to be honest, even with the noise cancellation at its lowest, you could only really hear the cars at the very beginning of the recording. So really good on that front. Also really nice how easy and seamless it was to record from the phone and then get the transcript and summary from HiNotes. So now let's take a look at a much longer transcription. This is an example of a real life meeting about how I can improve my CGI pipeline. And you can see the transcription quality is actually really good. Only a few minor mistakes like getting the name Chris mixed up with Crisp, but I really can't fault it for that. I've used a default template for this, but there's actually over 20 different templates to choose from with your pro membership. You can even access a YouTube template, which helps you extract key info from YouTube videos, really handy for learning exercises, for example. You can also see in this transcription is labeled each individual speaker, which is really great if you want to go back and listen to what a specific person has said, and it just breaks up the transcription really nicely. Moving to the summarization, this is really impressive. Over on the right hand side, you can see it summarized the key bits of the meeting, identified actionable points, and even given a reminder at the bottom that there is going to be another meeting due next week. I was particularly impressed with the meeting outline. This saves you so much time and condenses all of the meeting into short key packages of information that you can actually action. Overall, really impressed. Definitely one of the better AI note softwares I've tried. Specifically, the transcription accuracy was really good in comparison to others. I also really liked how easy it is to download and automatically upload recordings from the HiDock to HiNotes, so you've got everything at your fingertips. So AI note taking is nothing particularly new, and Samsung with the new S25 Ultra have recently added this feature alongside One UI 7 for free. So I guess the big question is, why not just use your phone, and why should you consider paying for something like the HiDock H1? There's a few reasons for this. The main one is simply convenience and practicality. The HiDock runs off mains power supply, so you don't need to worry about running out of battery during a longer meeting. Then there's the accuracy. My real world test and subsequent opinion of the Samsung S25 Ultra's AI notes was, it's helpful, but actually lags behind a lot compared to other AI note taking software I've tried. For example, the client in this meeting did not say this. This is all very well and good, but the HiDock H1 can actually go on sale for as much as $269. Surely that's not worth it. Well, it kind of is, and there's actually no doubt about it. The AI note-taking ability is just one component of the HiDock H1. Factor in the price of an average good docking station, then actually you're getting a lot of extra functionality for not that much money at all. Compare it to a cheaper docking station and you'll realize just how much extra you're getting for your money. What I don't like though is subscriptions. HiDock H1 doesn't actually have one. So if you do go ahead and buy the HiDock H1, you get a lifetime membership. So they're not calling it a subscription, they're calling it a membership. You don't really need to worry about it if you are buying this device anyway. HiNotes is almost a separate thing. So if you don't want to buy the HiDock H1, you can go ahead and use HiNotes on its own as a standalone software, I guess, but you will be introduced to a membership fee. But again, I repeat, you get a lifetime membership included with the HiDock for free. This gives you unlimited notes for summary templates, translation into and from over 50 different languages, I believe. Then there is a pro membership that's currently, I think, $199 per year, which adds features like being able to edit a speaker name, integration with Google Docs, and then being able to export in PDF format. Then there's over 20 different summary templates to choose from in there as well. In my opinion, if you're buying a HiDock H1, the membership that you get included with it will be just fine for many people. Only a very select few people will want to pay for that pro membership. Those sorts of people being high up line managers, for example, who have a lot of organizing and meetings to do. For the average Joe, I think you'll just be fine getting away with the regular subscription, which is again free with the HiDock H1. So overall, a really great piece of tech, especially when you stop and think about just how many problems the HiDock H1 is actually solving for you. But is the HiDock H1 worth the money? I could comfortably say with some certainty that it does warrant your hard-earned cash, especially at its current price of $269 or so. And it's even more worth it if you're in the market for a docking station anyway. I feel like you're getting a really solid docking station here, then a lot of really useful note-taking features on top for free. And then if you really wanted to get your money's worth, you could actually consider using the HiDock as a desktop speaker as well if you wanted to. That is a lot of product for $269. Let me know in the comment section what you think of the HiDock H1. There will be a link to check it out in the pinned comment and the description. But in the meantime, feel free to check out some other cool tech. Click in the top left or right hand corner now to go to that. For now though, I've been Alex. This has been Tech It Easy. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.